Good morning, party people. Johnny, do you know where one of my favourite places in Europe is?
Is it somewhere that's ruled by a king?
That's Florence.
Oh, yeah. Do they have machines there?
Yeah, nice try. Yeah. But actually, have you ever been to Florence?
Swing and a miss. No.
Oh, man, I have not. Love that place.
I have to do so much more of Europe. Like,
I didn't wish to. I have to do so much today.
I really do have to do so much more of Europe. And I'd love to. I'd love to.
Cool, great. Today we're checking out Florence the Machine. Oh, crap, these intros are getting worse and worse. The song's called King. I love Florence the Machine.
Florence and the Machine are a massive guilty pleasure. I won't even say guilty pleasure. They're just fantastic.
You shouldn't feel guilty. Her voice is just next level.
Oh, it's so good.
Have you seen that footage of her in the hospital room with the lady that was, I can't remember what song it was. Might have been Dog Days Are Over. But she's just singing a cappella to this lady who's stuck in hospital for something. Oh, and missed a concert or something. So she went to her hotel room and, hospital room and just sang for her. And it just gives me chills every time.
Fantastic.
That's not what we're watching today. We're watching the new track, which is called King.
Speaking of Dog Days Are Over, one of our favourites, Stick to Your Guns, did a cover of Dog Days Are Over by Florence and the Machine. If you've never heard it, go and check it out. Because I didn't know it existed until way after.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because I didn't even know that tribute album was a thing.
Oh, so it's go so and check good. That out. There's some, like, Ben Bruce from Asking Alexandria has a song on there. Born of Osiris have a song on there.
They do indeed.
It's a banging album.
Yeah, cool. You know what else is banging? These people's fingers on the like and subscribe.
I was worried where you were going with that.
Yeah.
3, 2, 1. Sure, John's an idiot, but copyright's much worse.
Check out the badge, dude. Well, fucking relax, dude.
Me, every time we stop recording, I have to join.
I can do this. Been a while.
We argue in the kitchen about whether to have children, about the world ending in the scale of my ambition, and how much is art really worth. The very thing you're best at is the thing that hurts the most. But you need your rotten heart, your dazzling pain like diamond rings. You need to go to
war. Looks like a purple Jedi.
I'm material to sing. I am a mother. I'm a bride.
I love that.
Yeah, it's great.
I need my golden crown of sorrow, my bloody sword to swing, my empty halls to echo with grand self-mythology. I am no mother. I am no bride. I am king.
Her falsetto is just fucking stupid. In a good way.
I know, I got that. That little layered harmony bit before where they had the really softly pulled back falsetto in behind. Ah, chef's kiss.
I am no mother. I am no bride.
Oh, what the fucking shit?
But a woman is a changeling, always shifting shape. Just when you think you have it figured out, something new begins to take. What strange claws are these scratching at my skin? I never. Coming from within, I am no mother, I'm a bride, I'm a king.
No, she doesn't look like a purple Jedi. I realize who she reminds me of now. Raven from Titans. From, you know, Teen Titans, Titans, DC, anyone?
I haven't watched it.
Oh, dude, you gotta watch Titans, it's great.
I just, DC lost me.
But DC TV, like, Titans is insane.
Where do you watch that?
It's on Netflix.
Oh.
Yeah. It's really good. It's 3 seasons. It's very adult.
Don't know if I'm mature enough for that. This is a weird, creepy film, but...
I need my golden crown of sorrow, my bloody sword to swing, I need my empty halls to echo with grand sails, mythology, 'cause I am no mother.
Absolute effortless strength.
Throaty,
yeah. Fantastic. Cool little bass pulses there. Oh! Everybody skip. Oh my god, I'm so sorry to stop it. It reminds me of Jim Carrey in the Tutu.
Has he had a long history of mental illness?
It... so
yeah,
good.
I can see that.
The vibe got very happy all of a sudden.
Reminds me of Scarlet Witch.
Yeah, fully.
I was never as good as I always thought I was, but I knew how to dress it up. I was never satisfied, never let me go, just drag me by my hair and look back on with a show.
Mum, get down. All right. It's not Mum.
Okay. How weird and creepy.
It was quite creepy, wasn't it?
Yeah.
But then, like, there was that moment at the end where the vibe just got all happy and, like...
Well, happily creepy.
They are just a really... spectacular band. Like, everything that they do sounds so grandiose and, like, orchestral and big. Like, there's always so many peaks and valleys and, like, really... They put a lot of... Like, one thing I've noticed about them, I don't love all of their songs, but... And that wasn't... That probably wasn't one of my favourites.
Mm-hmm.
But they always have this way of like, really having this real, like, grandiose crescendo.
Sorry. Fun fact, no special effects for your space video. Florence is actually an otherworldly being come to exalt us all with her voice.
Yeah, well, it explains the voice, doesn't it? Yeah. Yeah, they just have this really grandiose crescendo in all their songs where everything just sounds so big and it's like, we've finally reached that point, and then they taper off.
Yeah.
They do that quite a lot, and I really enjoy that.
I was going to say, it's not in all their songs, but yeah, no. They do have that part nailed down. And that was exactly that. It had that really beautiful build. I love how they let her voice really take you on a journey too, from those really soft, somber, stripped back, reserved moments of almost whispered lyrics into that big, the, like, I can't even begin to do it. The, like, that's
pretty close. and it's one of those things where you've got, like, obviously a really, really talented band, really good musicians, and finding that cohesion between such a strong, powerful voice, but giving the instruments enough, I guess, of the limelight.
Yeah.
Because there's always so much happening musically. And I feel like a lot of the time with bands that have such an insanely strong vocalist, it can kind of overshadow the complexity of the musicianship as well, because that's the focal point. And with a voice like that, like, it's understandable. Like, she's just insane. Sure. And insane in a good way. Please don't come and snap my neck like that, Florence.
Do it. What did you guys think of that? For those of you that are Florence and the Machine fans have come across, thanks for checking out the video. What did you guys think of it? And for our regular metalheads that are on here, do you like a bit of Florence? Comment, let us know your thoughts. We'll see you guys in the next video.
Whoa, I'm floating. Ow.